Henry Hank in the white trunks, Mauro Mina in the black, round five of the 10-rounder. No knockdowns. And now Mina seems to have taken the aggressive. So for the first time, he is moving in. Heavy left hook. Certainly the most active round of the fight. Mina has changed his style and is moving in with short punches. And he's using his right hand more. Madison Square Garden, Mauro Mina, the black trunks, Henry Hank, the white, is a light heavyweight. Hank, 170 3/4, the heaviest he has ever fought at, and Mina, 170 1/2. Mina's change of pace seems to have bothered Hank. He was backing away the first four rounds, is now moving in. Changed pace again, starting to box. There's Mina who is coming on now. And came back with good punches on his own. There has not been a clinch in the fight, and this is almost the end of round six. There's the bell ending round six. Next Saturday, the fight of the week moves to the Los Angeles Olympic for a 10-round lightweight match between battling Torres and Billy Collins. Torres is one of the outstanding lightweight prospects on the West Coast. This year he has had six fights and won every one of them by a knockout. One of his victories came in the first round, three in the third, one in the fourth, and only one foe was able to stay around as long as nine. He has won 48 out of 52 with 40 knockouts. Collins has a punch too. He KO'd Antonio Marcella and Tony Fortunato in his last two outings. Overall, he has won 32 out of 40 fights, scoring 23 knockouts. Battling Torres versus Billy Collins, 10 rounds or less, next Saturday on the Fight of the Week. By the Gillette Safety Razor Company and by General Cigar Company, makers of William Penn and White Owl Cigars. Coming up to round seven, and the contest is getting a bit closer. Hank got out in front first couple of rounds, but now it's Mina coming on. Mina is 6 feet one, Hank is 5 feet ten. Arthur McCanty, the referee, hasn't had too much to do so far. There have been no knockdowns. Gone round seven.